हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन टुडेज क्लास थ्रू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग। इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्ले द सिल्वर बॉक्स। इट इज़ अ प्ले रिटन बाय जॉन गॉल्सवर्थी एंड इट हैज़ बीन इंक्लूडेड इन BA पार्ट सेकेंड सिलेबस पेपर फर्स्ट पोइट्री एंड ड्रामा। This play, The Silver Box, has three parts, or we can say there are three acts in this play, The Silver Box. In previous class, we looked at the theme of the play of The Silver Box. The theme of the play is the idea that there is one law for the rich and another for the poor. In other words, the play shows that if a rich man and a poor man commit one and the same offense or crime, the rich man can escape the punishment while the poor man shall be punished by the law. Such is the power of wealth and money in our modern society. So students, in today's class, we will look at the character sketch of the play John Galsworthy. There are some important character in this play. First important character is John Barthwick, who is also member of parliament. Mrs. Barthwick, who is wife of John Barthwick. Jack Barthwick is the central figure of the play John The Silver Box. Mrs. Jones and Jones, these are some importance or the major characters of the play The Silver Box. The first important character of the play is Barthwick. So let's discuss about Barthwick. Barthwick, the father of Jack in the Silver Box, is a hypocritic. He belongs to the Liberal Party and is a member of Parliament. He uses slogans expressing his sympathy for the poor and the downtrodden, but backs out when he has to act. He is very keen and safeguarding the honor of his family. He is shocked to find that his son Jack has an illicit relationship with a disreputable woman and also stolen her purse containing a little more than £7. When the woman threatens to take action if the money is not restored to her, Barthwick gives her £8, which is much more than what his son owes her. This gesture is due not to any feeling of generosity, but to his wish to silence the woman and prevent her from spoiling the name of his family. After she leaves, he condemns his son for his irresponsible behavior. He calls him a nuisance to the community. But Jack faces his father coolly. He says that there is no love lost between them, that he has given money to the woman only for maintaining the honor of his family. Because of his wife's pressure, the theft of the silver box is reported to the police, who promptly arrest Jones. Jones threatens to expose Jack's clandestine relationship between the disreputable woman. This once again upsets Barthwick. He requests the solicitor to help him out of this crisis. He pretends to be sympathetic to the Jones and is prepared to withdraw the case against them. But the case has reached an advanced stage एंड द प्रोसीजिंग कैन नॉट बी स्टॉप्ड. सो ही इंस्ट्रक्ट द सॉलिसिटर टू हश अप द अफेयर ऑफ जैक्स स्टीलिंग हिज मिस्ट्रेस पर्स. बार्थविक इज रिलीव्ड ओनली व्हेन रोपर एग्रीज टू हेल्प हिम. इन द कोर्स बार्थविक आई विटनेसेस द सफरिंग ऑफ द लेवन्स चिल्ड्रन. ही प्रपोजेज टू टेल अप द कजिस इन फेवर ऑफ ऑर्फन चिल्ड्रन इन द हाउस. जॉन बार्थविक सीनियर इज अ पॉलिटिशियन. हिज एज इज बिटवीन 50 and 60 years. His forehead is bald and face is reddish. He looks to be quite an impressive person. He wears a pince-nez. He is a member of parliament and he belongs to Liberal Party. He is a very rich person. He prouds of his high status. He behaves towards others in a dignified manner. He believes himself to be a member of upper class of English society. He calls himself a liberal. At his breakfast table, he reads the newspaper called The Times. He is disturbed to read that the Labour man has won the one side seat in the by-election. Yet he believes that the representations of all the parties in the parliament is necessary for any proper social policy, for any proper reform. He is also not afraid of the socialist and the labor man. He firmly tells his wife that he is no alarmist. He has trust in the people. He also suggests that he is a man of principles. In the London police court, he is distressed by the case of Levens and his little girls. He tells his solicitor, Roper, that he will describe the condition of the poor in the parliament and fight for the cause of the poor people. But his conduct proves him to be hypocrite. His behavior towards his servants shows that he regards himself higher than they and superior to them. He himself moves the police regarding the theft of the silver box, but he is afraid to see that his own reputation may suffer if the offense of his son gets into the newspaper. He wants to withdraw the case of the theft of his silver box. His doings and thoughts presents him as a selfish politician. He is always ready to protect his political and social reputation. Outwardly, he speaks as if he were a moralist. He is shocked to see that Jack spent the night with a society girl and got drunk her. He angrily finds fault with Jack for doing all that. His words are noteworthy. To conclude, John Barthwick, we will say that he was a hypocritical and selfish politician. He was hypocritic. He has neither kindness nor remorse in his heart. He boasts of being a man of principles, but his wife is correct when she says, "Your principles are nothing but sheer fight." The best character is John Barthwick, who loves fine phrases and loudly professes liberal principles in the tone of a man, making speeches to his constituents, but who promptly turns cool the moment his interests are threatened or his name is likely to be associated with a public scandal. Another important character of the play is Mrs. Barthwick, who is wife of Mr. Barthwick. Mrs. Barthwick is similar to her husband in certain respect and dissimilar in certain other respects. Like her husband, she is harsh towards servants. She complains that servants are no longer loyal, but conspire against their masters. She speaks with concern of how her friend Lady Holyrood, maidservant, defied her in spite of her open flirtation with a man, and demanded a month's wages in lieu of notice. Mrs. Barthwick is very conservative in the matter of man-woman relationship. She is alarmed to learn that her maid, Mrs. Jones, had an illicit affair with her husband, even before marrying him. She pressurizes Roper to expose the Jones' sexual relationship in the court. Roper coolly rejects her suggestion, saying that it is irrelevant to the case and that even the magistrate might have had such an affair. Thou severely condemning the lapses of others, Mrs. Barthwick is kind to her son Jack, despite his misconduct. She pats him and lovingly inquires about his headache, even after coming to know about his illegal relationship with a low woman. Mrs. Barthwick has a touch of humanity of which her husband is devoid. She hears the sound of John's little son crying for his mother and is moved to tears. She asks her husband to withdraw the case against the Jones, but he declines, saying that it is out of his hands. There is no love lost between the Barthwicks. After Roper leaves, they swear at each other. Barthwick says that his wife has not the imagination even of a fly. Mrs. Barthwick retorts against him by saying that he is a coward person. Now we will discuss Jack Barthwick, who is a son of John Barthwick. Young Jack Barthwick is satirized in the opening scene. He is drunk and talks nonsense. He says that there is a very little difference between socialism and liberalism. He is wrong totally. Further, he says that he is a liberal like his father. But he also says that the concept of equality is rot and silly. Jack, son of Barthwick, is an irresponsible criminal. He does not do any work to support himself. He has been educated at Oxford, but does not seem to have acquired any skill. He is utterly dependent on his father. Even his tailoring expenses are met by his father. He gives a check to the tailor without enough money in his account. He contracts an illicit relationship with a disreputable woman. He knows the woman is too poor to pay rent for her house and yet steals her money. To justify his action, he says that he took her money merely to escort her off. When she comes to his house to recover the money, he first tries to shake her off by saying that he does not know her. Barthwick is worried about the need to safeguard the reputation of his family. Though he is the only child of the family, Jack does not realize it is his responsibility to protect his family. In the court, he does what he has been briefed to do by the solicitor Roper. He says that he has never seen Jones. He denies having admitted Jones into his room and encouraged him to drink whiskey. He suppresses the truth about his affair with an unknown lady. Instead of admitting the truth that he spent the night with his mistress, he says that he spent the time in the theater एंड हैविंग ड्रंक शैम्पेन एक्सेसिवली लीविंग द लैचिक इन द टूअर ही फॉल्स एसलीप इन ऑन द सोफा जोन्स और हिज वाइफ माइट हैव बीन टेकन द थिंग्स ही डज नॉट स्पेसिफाई वॉट द थिंग्स आर फॉर फियर दैट इट वुड बी लीड हिम टू एडमिट हिज हैविंग स्टॉलन हिज मिस्ट्रेस पर्स वाइल गिविंग एविडेंस ही हेजिटेट्स समटाइम्स विच इंडिकेट्स दैट हिज कॉन्शियसनेस इज स्टिल अलाइव बट दाउ ही फील्स अनइजी टू रील ऑफ लाइज ही नेवर कन्फेसेस द ट्रूथ वेन द ट्रायल इज ओवर एंड जोन्स इज लेड टू प्रिजन जैक फील्स इमेंसली रिलीव एंड वॉक्स आउट ऑफ द कोर्ट विथ अ ट्रम्पेंट एयर. Now we will discuss Jones, who is also a major character of the play The Silver Box. James Jones is about 30 years age. He is underfed and has hollow cheeks. There are black circles round his eyes. He is unemployed and poor, so he wears rusty clothes. Chill penury and unemployment have cast a damp over his spirits. So he walks in a hangdog manner. By profession, he is groom. He lost his job about 9 years ago, for he had illicit relationship with Mrs. Jones before he married her. The cause of his unemployment is the growing fashions of keeping motor cars instead of horse carriage. He has become a drunkard. His unemployment and hardships have preyed upon his mind. James Jones has also become a violent man. The causes are two, his unemployment and wine drinking. Jones represents the lower state of society. Galsworthy deliberately avoids presenting him as model to be followed. In fact, he loads with most revolting ways. He is presented as an incorrigible drunkard, beating his wife and even suspecting her fidelity. He drives her out of home late in the night and then follows her to find out if she has any lovers running after her. Jones' drinking, which is the most cause of all his vices, is due to his not getting a job in spite of his ceaseless search. He is disgusted not only with rich employers who look at him most scornfully, but also with trade unions who arrange rallies and demonstrations of hordes and unemployment men and women, only to get money out of them. He says that he would rather starve than search any more for a job. Does John loves his wife and children? Mrs. Jones accuses him of being unconcerned about the welfare of the family. She particularly charges that he has a mistress and spends all he earns on her. When the police arrest her and prepare to take her away, he admits that it was he who stole the silver box. What is more, he assaults the police to prevent them from taking his wife away. In the court, he asserts violently that he would beat the police again if they laid hands on his wife again. He says that any manly man would do only this. It is this violent behavior that leads the magistrate to conclude that he is mentally disordered and sentenced him to imprisonment. James Jones is also a very sensitive person. In Act 2, Scene 1, he says that he feels great misery when people refuse him a job. When he asks for a job, the boss botches him up and down. He is angry that he seeks a job every day but does not get it. All the above reasons have made him spiteful of the rich, but he is not a criminal at heart or in his senses. James Jones is a social rebel in the making. He notices that the principle of equality before the law is a farce. He also notices that a poor man's right to injustice is also a legal fiction. So he does not wish that his case should go to the jury. On the whole, we can say that Jones is not a bad man. He harms nobody except his wife and himself. According to one critic, he is representative of the poor unemployment. The rich, like Mrs. Warthwick, may call him a ruffian, but such a word cannot be applied to describe him. He is only a sullen rebel who groans out his sufferings under the bait of the world. Now we will discuss Mrs. Jones, who is wife of James Jones. Mrs. Jones, described by Jones as a very meek woman who does not have the spirit even of a louse. She is ill-treated by her husband, who goes to the extent of suspectively her fidelity. Yet she does not break with him. She is advised by a mad servant to devise her husband, but she never thinks along these lines. She is the only person in the play who traces effects to cause. She says that her husband drinks because he is employed and commits crimes because he is in drunken state. Mrs. Jones is deeply attached to her children. It is most painful to see her working as a charwoman in different houses to support her three children. She talks to the magistrate about her children. He says that this is an irrelevant matter and she meekly agrees with him. At the end of the play, also, she does not do anything violent to protest against her husband's imprisonment. The magistrate acquits her alone. She knows how difficult it is to get a job. She makes a worthless appeal to Warthwick to help her, but he makes a gesture of refusal and walks out of the court. What will be the fate of Mrs. Jones and her children? The trial of the Levins at the beginning of the third act presents a clue to the future. Like Mrs. Levins, Mrs. Jones may also throw morality to the winds and become a streetwalker, and her children may be taken to a public house.